Yo, my name's Dylan Sprayberry.
Hey, I'm Angela.
And we're shooting for RedHilton.com.
We're on Melrose, so come check it out.
I didn't really realize it until I started filming that I was going to be a series regular, which is, it's really awesome. And I mean, I already felt like I was one from season 4, but now it's just official, now it's on paper. Well, I auditioned for the young Derek character, which was in season 3B, and I got really, really close. It was me and one other guy, and basically I was too young. I was too young for that part, but Jeff really took a liking to me, and he said he would, you know, have me back for something else. And then a year later, I get the call to come audition for this, and the rest is history. I don't want to say they wrote it for me, but they definitely had me in mind to come in and audition for it, you know. He kept me in good thoughts. Well, Liam and Mason, our friendship is definitely going to be a lot more prominent this season. Last season, you definitely got to see a little bit of us, you know. Like, you could tell that we really cared for each other as friends. But this season, you'll get to see a lot more of it. And it's definitely a lot of us kind of portraying that old Scott and Styles relationship from the first season. Liam is definitely a lot more, I don't want to say I'm sure of myself, but he definitely has a lot more insecurities due to the fact that he has some mental issues, and you know, his family life isn't, he has a good family now, but he hasn't always had a good family. So he has some insecurities in that, in his past, that affect him, I think. Which I don't. I've come from a great family, and I've been raised to kind of believe in myself and do what I think is best for myself. And he didn't always have that. But I think we definitely have some of the same morals, as in, you know, protecting our friends, and just really, you know, caring about what's right and wrong. Teen Wolf season 5 in 5 words. As crazy as my mom. Yeah. Intense, disgusting, hilarious, dark. Are those all adjectives? and brooding. If I could play someone in a biopic, it would probably be Eddie Vedder from Pearl Jam or Corey Taylor from Slipknot. Well, I feel like music influences everything I do, but definitely in the way I dress, you know, and obviously with when my music changes, the way I like to portray myself changes. Everything usually pertains with rock. Like, that's usually where I kind of float around in, different styles of rock. I don't really go outside of that too much. I mean, there's like blues and jazz and stuff like that that I do like. It's anywhere from, you know, Led Zeppelin to like the heaviest metal you could think of. But yeah, I'm into all kinds of different music. I liked that Lady Gaga song, Applause. I liked that song for a long time. I think I still have it on my iPhone. It's a catchy song. This is All Black, which is basically the way I dress. Got my all black Converse, my all black skinny jeans, all black Top Man shirt. It's a little bit of plaid. And this is just a collaborative of my stuff with the stylist as well. I think it just depends on what mood I'm in, you know? Right now I'm in like an all black rocker kind of mood. So that's what I've been staying in. Hard for me to want to play anything else because I've already done like Superman, and I feel like sometimes doing too many superheroes as like the same actor, it gets kind of crazy. I definitely would like to play the actual Superman though. That would be cool. I always like villains. I like the super villains a lot. I really wanted to play the Joker. I think that would be cool. I thought it would be so hard now. The bar is so high to play the Joker now, but I would enjoy, you know, trying to do that. And just dream role in general, I think, just playing musicians that have really, you know, like, broke the norm in our culture. Something you don't know about me. I'm left-handed. Did you know that? There you go, you didn't know that. I like to stay in shape. I like to keep up my boxing and just play music and you try to get other parts while I have a break and just do different things and really just explore. A crazy story from a fan. I remember I was with Mason Dye and we were in Texas and these two fans, they were girls, they came up behind us and grabbed our butts, like a handful of our butts. And like, it was very aggressive and that happened and it kind of put a wrap on the rest of the day for us. I mean, we weren't mean to them. We were just, it like really took us off guard because they came up from behind and just kind of like attacked our butts. It's great to get to talk to them whenever I go to these conventions and they have all these stories about, you know, how Teen Wolf has really helped them or just they say funny things. They have funny things to say too. And they're always very genuine.
Yo, that's a wrap.
Thanks for checking out the shoot. Hope you guys like the photos.